On behalf of the members of the Minnesota Symphonic Winds, I'd like to welcome you to our video performance of a Spring Pops Showcase, a project we put together over the past 4 months to allow us to make music together virtually, as well as to take an interesting look at our past recorded repertoire. I'm Timothy Marr, and it's my distinct pleasure and honor to be the music director and conductor of the Minnesota Symphonic Winds. We've enjoyed looking back over our past concerts to select an engaging variety of works to help us all celebrate the coming of spring. Last fall, we produced a couple of virtual band performances for our holiday concert video, and we all had a challenging and rewarding experience doing this. And, well, we thought we'd do it again. So, what's on the program, you might ask? Well, after a deep dive into our recorded archives, we found that the upcoming concert centered on works that were either created for the Minnesota Symphonic Winds or composed by Minnesota-related composers, as well as compositions that revealed the kinds of music that we enjoy performing. Our two virtual projects present the work of Kelijah Dunton and Rick Kirby. Dunton's work, Stillwater, is based upon his experiences in our own very beautiful Stillwater, Minnesota. Kirby's An American Fanfare is an exhilarating patriotic expression. A short segment by bassoonist Andy Erickson will explain how these fascinating virtual projects were created. We present the exciting work Celebrations in honor of the recent passing of John Zdechlik, one of Minnesota's great composers and a dear friend to our band. We share works by Erica Svano and Andrew Boyson Jr. that we presented recently at our 2020 performance at the Minnesota Music Educators Midwinter Clinic, right before the pandemic shut everything down. Dr. Svano was our guest conductor for this particular concert, leading a spirited rendition of her piece, Shelley Meets Frankenstein. The Boyson work, March for Time, was commissioned by the Minnesota Symphonic Winds, as were two additional pieces performed at other concerts. One, simply called Play, was by our adopted Minnesotan, Carl Holmquist, and the other was an overture taken from a lengthy work about the instruments of the band by Minnesotan Dan Kallman, entitled Yankee Doodling. This latter recording was conducted by William Webb, now Associate Conductor Emeritus of the Minnesota Symphonic Winds, on our tour to Singapore back in 2003. Bill recently produced the video version of this piece that you'll enjoy in the upcoming performance. Our current associate conductor, Paul Kyle, explores a fantastical world, unleashing the band on the intriguing work Machu Picchu by Satoshi Yagasawa, as well as Julie Giroux's stunningly beautiful Riften Wed. And we enjoy offering an exquisite march as we take a fond look back at the history of the wind band performance found in our very own state of Minnesota. The piece, entitled En Route, was written by Minnesotan Joseph C. Hoffmeister a little over 100 years ago to bolster troop morale. Finally, we'd like to publicly acknowledge the members and friends of MSW who were on the production team for this presentation. Andy Erickson and Morgan May are to be thanked for their work on the virtual band videos. Bob Klein and Daryl Owens, as well as William Webb, for adding visual images to our recordings, and Eric Dungan for pulling it all together into this complete production. We'd like to thank our guest composer, conductor, Erica Svano, our associate conductor, Paul Kyle, and the manager of the Minnesota Symphonic Winds, Jill Westermeyer. The Minnesota Symphonic Winds officers and the members of its board provide wonderful visionary guidance as well. And finally, we'd like to thank all of the performing members of the Minnesota Symphonic Winds, past and present, who gave of their talents and their spirit in the performance of the works that you're about to hear. And now, please enjoy a Spring Pops Showcase. Thank you.
In 2003, the Minnesota Symphonic Winds toured to Singapore and performed in one of Asia's finest concert halls, the Esplanade Theater. MSW is celebrating its 25th anniversary and performed a joint concert at the Esplanade Theater with Singapore's Tanjong Katong Girls School as they celebrated their 50th anniversary. MSW members experienced wonderful tours of Singapore, and in preparation for their joint performance at the Esplanade, they did joint rehearsals, and MSW members led various sectionals for the Tanjong Katong students. For MSW's 20th anniversary, 5 years earlier, Minnesota composer Daniel Kallman was commissioned to write a 28-minute work entitled Yankee Doodling, A Young Person's Guide to the Concert Band. In Singapore, William Webb conducted the overture from Yankee Doodling that you will hear now, combined with various photographs from throughout the Singapore tour. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Andy Erickson, and I've played bassoon in the Minnesota Symphonic Winds for 25 years. For the last month and a half, I've had the privilege to work with the band to produce several virtual ensembles that will be premiered during today's program. We thought it might be interesting for you to see a quick explanation of how these are put together. It all starts by putting together a guide track. This guide track is a video of our conductor, Tim Marr, conducting along to a recording. We send the guide track out to the members of the band so that they can record a video of themselves playing their part. It is important that they watch and listen to the guide track so all of the parts line up and are in tune. These videos are then uploaded to a Google Drive folder and shared with me. I download each one and sort them by section, then I go to work creating the audio mix. First, I extract the audio from each video and edit and mix the sound for each section. After all of the sections are mixed, they are put together to create the sound for the full ensemble. Next comes the video. I'm sure others have their own way of doing this, but I combine the individual videos to produce different groups or scenes. These might be full sections all on the screen together, or different groups of instruments that all play at the same time during the piece. Depending on the piece of music, there could be several dozen of these groups. Finally, these groups or scenes are arranged with the audio mix so that every member of the band is on screen at least once, ideally when their part plays an important role in the music. I'd like to thank you for watching today. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Folks, we have a really special treat next with our excursion music, En Route. This is a march that has been hiding from the public for decades, and we're just so excited to be able to have a chance to bring it to light again. You can read in the program note, or you could read in the St. Paul Pioneer Press. They had a nice article about the background of this piece that it has a Minnesota connection and an interesting story behind it and a very interesting family behind it as you dig deeper and deeper. Joseph Hofmeister was born in the 1860s, and when he was a young man, he came to Minnesota, emigrated here, and quite the musician. He ended up becoming involved with the military band scene when he was pulled into the service. No small wonder he had already had some activity in that area. And through the course of his time with the regimental bands of Minnesota, he composed, he created music for them. And this is a work that he wrote when he was with the 2nd Regimental Band, and it was written for that time when they went off in 1916 to fight the war on the Mexican border. And I know that Don Hofmeister is here somewhere. I'm assuming it might be you. Thank you very much for helping bring this back to light. You are the grandson? This is Don Hofmeister, the grandson. Good to have you here. Oh, and a great-great-grandson. There you go. Excellent. And so, you know, we blow the dust off this score and we bring it back to life. And I hope that it will have a long life after this. We will launch it this evening and keep it in our repertoire. En Route by Joseph Hofmeister. Thank you.
On behalf of the Minnesota Symphonic Winds, I'd like to thank you for your support. Viewing this concert today means that you care about music making. We've had a tough time this past year in that we haven't been able to get together. We've been doing these virtual projects. It's time to go live, and we're going to do that on Wednesday, June 16th at 7 p.m. at Centennial Lakes Park in Edina, Minnesota, in the year of our Lord, 2021. We hope to see you there.
Thank you. Thank you.